Hello and welcome to Scratch Forum Replies. Today we have vincentearnabal asking, Hi, I'm working on a game that includes a torch in it. The idea is that a room, it's pitch dark, but you can use your torch to reveal parts of the room. This is how it should look like. The illuminated part follows the cursor so you can choose where to see. I tried making a big black square with a transparent circle and using this program. When fly click, forever, go to cursor. But the square isn't big enough for the screen. Anybody knows a solution? So I think this idea should probably work. I'm interested to see what happens when the cursor is too big for the screen. So let's start out with your idea of making a transparent circle. Purple side needs to be transparent, and the blue side needs to be black, like that. And this isn't really square right now. What I'm doing is looking at these numbers. Not sure if there's a better way. I probably could have drawn it with the modifier key to begin with, but that's pretty good, or at least good enough to get the idea. And so your idea, if I understand it right, is that you would say that the object would go to the mouse point like that. So that seems to work pretty well. And then what you want is there to be some extra polygon around this. So let's start with maybe one like this, and we'll make it entirely black, and then use the control point editor to try to get this to line up. I'll just do a sort of partway job here. Actually, I haven't used this editor much. Is it possible? There we go. Big as we possibly can. That one, or that one, or that one. And there we go. That's a little bit of a hole here. Alright. So here, you see that it's not quite big enough. The first thing I'm curious about is if we made it much larger, but I see that doesn't work. So, what you will probably also want to do, I'm thinking the quickest thing that I can think of doing is to create more of these. Of this is probably not going to be the absolute best, but it'll at least give the idea. So when I click here, We'll move this large black square to be north of the square with the hole in it. So, for example, we actually want to find the. X position and Y position of sprite 1 like this, and then maybe we would move to the Y position plus a bunch. So Y position would go here and we'd say, you know, plus 200 or something, and then this would just say go to that X position and this Y position here. So now when we click the flag, it's a little bit hard to tell what's going on, so let's change the color of this one to some bright color. That's pretty obvious. And so we turned this red just to see what was going on a little bit, and this 200 seems not quite enough, so let's add some value to it. And then what we can actually do is maybe clone this a few times, or you could just make several copies of this sprite. So I'll do that right now. Oops. Duplicate several times, and then this one is working, so you can make that black. There we go. And this one, you can put it at -500. Oh, I'm editing the hidden one. There we go, that's better. And then sprite 4. Let's show it. We'll alter the X position. Like so. That looks like it'll work pretty well. And then for sprite 3. Clone sprite 4 again. I'll do -500. That may not have worked. Let's turn this black. That was a little bit tearing because of the delay, so the fact that there's several of these one green flag clicked. Scripts is causing a bit of a race condition. I'll put a link in a card on the video for our explanation for what to do about that. That'll be the meantime, let's just turn this black and see how it looks. This needs a little bit of tweaking. Maybe have some extra cones in the corners or something like that. But I think that this basically will work. The last thing I suppose that we should do is just put some sort of sprite. It sounded like you checked that one. Okay, this guy will just go to the back layer. And there he is. So, it's kind of like the flashlight effect. And as you shine the flashlight around, you can see what's behind this black layer. Just like that. Hope that was helpful, and thank you for watching.